Hi, this is Jack from ChineseLongsword.com. Just a quick video to share with you the number one reason why the spear is so powerful. Okay, let me just give it to you up front. The reason why the spear is so powerful is because you can do this. Okay, so what this does is that if I'm standing here, let's say I cannot reach my opponent yet, but without moving at all, if I just do this, I will immediately extend my reach, and that helps me to reach my opponent. Now, if I were using a sword, let's say this is a Dadao, right? Now, where I am standing right now, let's say I cannot reach my opponent, I would have to make a step to get closer to him in order to get in range to attack him. Okay, but if I was using a spear, like I said earlier, okay, you'll be able to just stay where you are and extend your reach, okay, and immediately hit the other person. So this saves you a lot of time, because making a step, okay, is going to take a longer time. But if you were to just use your hand this way, okay, just strike the weapon down this way, then it is a much faster and easier process that you can quickly get nearer to the other person, okay, much faster than if you were to make a use footwork to get nearer. So that's the number one reason, which I think is why the spear is so powerful. Now, what I have here is actually a wooden bayonet rifle. Okay, so even though the bayonet is longer, much longer, okay, this is according to historical proportions. So this is about 170 centimeters long. Okay, so according to the actual proportion of the Japanese bayonet rifle. So even though they have a longer weapon, but they can't really do this, they can't really let go and trust in handling because it's too heavy, or they can't really slide because there's a lot of things here, like they have the magazine port, ejection port, and some other stuff. It's not as smooth as this, so they can't really do this. Okay, so they are now fixed. So where I'm holding right now is, that's it, I can't slide and do whatever. So I can only do this with a bayonet rifle. I can't do this. Okay, I can only do this. Now, so from my front hand till the end of the weapon, so this is the length, okay? Now, if I were to compare this to the Dadao, right? Notice that it's approximately about the same. Okay, about the same. So, I believe this may be one of the reasons why the Dadao was effective against the Japanese bayonet. Okay, even though overall the Dadao is shorter. Okay, that's because the Japanese soldier cannot slide their weapon. I mean, of course they can, but it won't be as smooth. Okay, and they can't let go. They can, of course, but if they miss, then that's it. They can't recover in time because the weapon is too heavy. Okay, but in any case, the number one reason that I think why the spear is so powerful is because you can immediately extend your reach by sliding the weapon or letting go of one hand and doing this. If you want, you can give it a try at your next sparring practice. Get the spear person, the person using the spear, to hold the spear and fix it his grip. That means he can't slide, he can't do this, just hold it this way, and he can only thrust this way. And do he can block, of course, but he can't slide, he can only hold it this way, and he can only thrust this way. Get him to do that, you'll notice that he will lose a big portion of his advantage of using the spear. Okay, give it a try and let me know what you think. Okay, thank you.